Welcome to our service this morning. I hope you've all had a lovely Christmas and festive time. Romans chapter 15 verse 13 says, "May God, the source of hope, fill you with joy and peace by means of your faith in him, so that your hope will continue to grow by the power of the Holy Spirit." Shall we begin our service today by singing our first hymn, "It Came Upon a Midnight Clear"?
It came upon the midnight clear, that glorious song of old, from angels bending near the earth to touch their harps of gold. Peace on the earth, goodwill to men, from heaven's all-gracious King. The world in solemn stillness lay to hear the angels sing. Still through the cloven skies they come, with peaceful wings unfurled, and still their heavenly music floats o'er all the weary world. Above its sad and lonely plains, they bend on hovering wing, and ever over its babble sounds the blessed angels sing.
Thank you.
pray. Heavenly Father, we come to you in prayer and we say thank you for the festive time that we've had. We thank you for our family and for our friends. Father, we thank you for seeing us through another year, and we thank you for the food that we've eaten, the drinks we've drank, and the safety that we have felt in our homes. Lord, we thank you for our church and the way that we have been able to celebrate the birth of your Holy Son this year. Lord, we thank you. Amen. Let us say the Lord's Prayer.
Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name.
Thy kingdom come.
Thine will be done,
on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day
our daily bread.
Forgive us our trespasses,
as we forgive those
who sin against us.
And lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom,
the power and the glory,
forever and ever.
Bible reading comes from Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 12.
Jesus was born in the town of Bethlehem in Judea during the time when Herod was king. When Jesus was born, some wise men from the east came to Jerusalem. They asked, "Where is the baby who was born to be the king of the Jews? We saw his star in the east and have come to worship him." When King Herod heard this, he was troubled, as well as the people of Jerusalem. Herod called a meeting of all the leading priests and the teachers of the law and asked them where the Christ would be born. They answered, "In the town of Bethlehem in Judea. The prophet wrote about this in the scriptures. But you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judea, are important among the tribes of Judea. A ruler will come to you. He will be like the shepherd of my people of Israel." Then Herod had a secret meeting with the wise men and learned from them that the exact time they first saw the star. He sent the wise men to Bethlehem, saying, "Look carefully for the child. You will find him. Come and tell me so I can worship him too." After the wise men heard the king, they left. The star they had seen in the east went before them until it stopped above the place where the child was. When the wise men saw the star, they were filled with joy. They came to the house where the child was and saw him with his mother Mary. And they bowed down and worshipped him. They opened their gifts and gave him treasures of gold, frankincense and myrrh. But God warned the wise men in a dream not to go back to Herod. So they returned to them, to their own country, by a different way.
Our second hymn is We Three Kings. So shall we sing together? Our Three Kings of Orient Time.
Guide us to Thy, guide us to Thy, guide us to Thy perfect life. We three kings of all it are, bearing gifts we traveled so far, field and fountain, moor and mountain, following yonder star. Star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to Thy, guide us to Thy, guide us to Thy perfect light. Born a king, king on Bethlehem's plain. Gold I bring to crown him again. King forever, ceasing never over us all to reign. Star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy, guide us to thy, guide us to thy perfect. Star of wonder, star of night, star with royal beauty bright, westward leading, still proceeding, guide us to thy, guide us to thy, guide us to thy perfect love.
Our second reading comes from Luke chapter 2, verses 8 to 20. That night, some shepherds were in the field nearby watching their sheep. Then the angel of the Lord stood before them. The glory of the Lord was shining around them, and they became very frightened. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid." I am bringing you good news and will bring you great joy to all the people. Today your Saviour was born in the town of David. He is Christ the Lord. This is how you will know him. You will find a baby wrapped in pieces of cloth and lying in a feeding box. Then a very large group of angels from heaven joined the first angel, praising God and saying, "Give glory to God in heaven, and on earth let there be peace among the people who please God." Then the angels, Then the angels left them and went back to heaven. The shepherds said to each other, "Let's go to Bethlehem. Let's see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So the shepherds went quickly and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the feeding box. When they had seen him, they told what the angels had said to them about this child. Everyone was amazed at what the shepherds had said to them, but Mary treasured these things and continued to think about them. Then the shepherds went back to their sheep, praising God and thanking him for everything that they had seen and heard. It had been just as the angel had told them. He was born in a simple two-bed house in Tupelo, Mississippi. He was born on the 8th of January 1935. He has a twin brother, Jess Garon, who is stillborn, leaving him to grow up as an only child. His early years were spent in poverty, with his mum Gladys working as a cotton picker, and his dad going from one job to another. When he was 11 years old, he asked his parents for a bike, which he so desperately wanted. Unfortunately, his parents couldn't afford a bike, so they persuaded him to have a guitar. As he left school, he did a variety of jobs. He also went on to night school and studied to be an electrician. Doesn't sound much of a life that would make anyone stand up and take much notice. Just a normal average guy, a nobody. Who would have thought that he would achieve anything special, that he'd become so famous that people know him by his first name only? His name is Elvis Presley. Adored by millions, he went on to star in 33 successful films and sold over 1 billion records worldwide, more than any other artist. He is regarded as one of the most important figures in the 20th century within popular culture. That's quite some nobody. As we heard in our second reading, Luke, we heard how Jesus' birth was very humble setting and beginning. Being in a stable, no room at the inn. When Jesus was born, being placed in animal feeding troughs. Yet some shepherds and wise men were told how special Jesus would be when he was grown up. What do you think God has planned for our lives? I doubt very much that I am going to be a top-selling multi-million pound artist. The singing gene hasn't quite reached me in our family, unfortunately. But you never know, maybe one day Simon Cowell will be like, she's the one. I invite you after this service to write your thoughts down of what you'd like to do in 1, 5, 10 years time and keep them in a safe place and then look down at them every now and again, because you never know just how far you will have come. Our third hymn is While the Shepherds Watch Their Flock. Come to the time in our service where we pray for ourselves and others. So shall we pray? Heavenly Father, we thank you for the year that we have had this year, and we ask that you'll be with each and every person who has suffered so greatly this year. We ask that you'll be with each family member and friends who have lost loved ones this year. We ask that you'll be with the people who have born new life in 2020, got married, started new relationships, decided that they want to follow you and your ways. Lord, This year has been so difficult in so many ways across the whole world. We ask that you'll be with those who are living in poverty. We thank those who have given so much for the people who are in need. The voluntary groups, people donating their time, their money, their items, their homes. We pray that you'll be with the leaders of our country as we go into another year full of so much hope and positivity. Unsure of what the next year will hold, we know that you will face it with your help. Lord, we pray for our church. In 2020, our wonderful church would have been 188 years old. Our church has seen so many families come and go, two world wars, a global pandemic, and so much heartbreak as families said goodbye to their loved ones during funerals. But yet so much joy and happiness and love during weddings, christenings and baptisms. Lord, this year our church hasn't been used as much as we would have liked. However, we thank you for our church to still being there, remaining firm in our community. We look forward to reopening your house next year and welcoming our church members and new friends into our church family. Lord, we lift up to you our families. This year we have spent so much time apart from our extended families, the people that we don't live with. Lord, we pray that you will be with those who are poorly and in need of medical treatment and offer them the support and love that they need. Father, as we go into a new year, we pray that you will grant us a vision of how to live our lives in your way. We pray that each of us will have a happy and healthy and worry-free 2021. Amen. We have now come to our final hymn in our service today. So let us sing joyfully our final hymn, Joy to the World. Service of 2020. I wish you all a very happy and healthy 2021, and please stay safe however you are going to be bringing in the new year. I hope that the new year brings us lots of joy, happiness and good health. Whatever 2021 will bring, I'm sure it will be in the Lord's plan. So I will hopefully see you very soon. Happy New Year.
Goodwill to all the earth and peace divine.